Hi, this machine is my experiment at building a hollow chisel mortiser out of wood.
I started with one of these drill press hollow chisel mortiser kits. I had to cut the bracket for this kit apart so that I could fit a hand drill into it. I mounted my chisel holder with this part cut out on a piece of plywood, and it actually sticks into the plywood a little bit here so that it can push up against the plywood, because you need to apply an awful lot of force when you're hollow chisel mortising. And then on these blocks here, I mount my hand drill, and there's another block here that attaches it securely in place, and then I can put my chisel in here, and that lines up exactly with the chuck, and it's one of these older style keyed chucks, so I can get in here and tighten that up with the key. The chisel holder and drill are attached to this piece of plywood, which has got these rails attached to here, which makes a sliding dovetail, and it slides on this part here. This whole drill and chisel and dovetail assembly attaches to a stand here. This is actually part of my joint strength test, and then I just fasten it on here with a bar clamp. The whole thing is an experiment, so I didn't really want to build a dedicated stand for it. Then at the top, I've got this part here, which is a little bit loose, and two big carriage bolts that attach to my lever. And with that, I can plunge the whole mechanism, and I have a lot of mechanical advantage because it takes an awful lot of force to plunge one of these hollow chisel mortisers into the wood. Unfortunately, with this cheap drill, it's a hammer drill, and even with the hammer function turned off, this drill chuck will actually move into the drill a little bit when I'm mortising, so I have to actually leave an extra little bit of slack on the bottom of my chisel, because these hollow chisel mortising chisels, the drill that goes into here is not meant to rub against the actual chisel itself. It needs to protrude, and I need to protrude it an extra little bit so that when the wood pushes it up, it still doesn't ram into the chisel. The drill that I'm using is a really cheap hammer drill. It only cost me about $20, and it's too high at RPM, so it would be better to have one with more gear reduction and this whole chuck issue as well. But other than that, it's about right. To get the right kind of drill, there's a DeWalt drill that would be perfect, but that costs $150. And a brand new cheap hollow chisel mortiser only costs $200. So it really doesn't make much sense to spend a lot of money trying to build a cheap hollow chisel mortiser if you can buy one for that little money.
Let's have a closer look inside those mortises.
The problem with hollow chisel mortises is that the bottom of the mortise just isn't very clean. It's because when the chisel comes in, the drill has to cut a little bit ahead of the chisel, and then the chisel has got these sort of curves in here, so it doesn't actually remove all the chips, so the bottom of the mortise just isn't clean. So you'd really have to clean it up with a hand chisel if you want your tenon to come all the way down. Now my mortiser is a little bit worse, but this mortise here was actually cut with a real professional mortiser, and you see similar results. It's just not very clean, and the sides are not very clean either. It's because the chisel is just essentially pushed straight down, and that makes the cut. So it's really not a very elegant way of making mortises.
A slot mortiser by comparison will cut a lot faster, and it will cut a lot cleaner.
So overall, I don't think it really makes that much sense to build your own hollow chisel mortiser, especially when you consider how cheap you can buy those. If you are going to build a mortiser, it would be much better to build a slot mortiser, or maybe even my panto rotor, because those machines do a much better job of mortising, they're much quicker, and they're much more expensive to buy new.